Goodwill Community Foundation, creating opportunities for a better life.
Excel worksheets can have a lot of cells, and sometimes you may find that you want to view two different parts of the spreadsheet at the same time. For example, in this spreadsheet I have a list of salespeople in the first column, but when I scroll to the right, those names disappear, which makes it really hard to see who the sales data belongs to. We can fix this by freezing the first column, so it will always stay visible. First, go to the View tab, and click Freeze Panes. And you have a few different options, but we just want to freeze the first column. Now when we scroll, we can easily see the names of each salesperson, no matter where we are in the spreadsheet. This spreadsheet also has dates in the second row, and I'd like to freeze them so they'll stay visible when I scroll down. But in this example though, it's going to work a bit differently, and that's because it's row 2. And you can see why if I go to the Freeze Panes command. There's an option to freeze the top row, but there isn't an option to freeze just the second row by itself. Instead, we'll need to freeze the top two rows. Since we've already frozen the first column, we'll first need to reset the spreadsheet by selecting Unfreeze Panes. And now you have two options. You can either select the row below the rows that you want to freeze, that's row 3 in this case, or you can select a single cell, such as B3. If you select only one cell, it will freeze the rows above it, and also any columns to the left, and that's exactly what we want here. Next, go to the Freeze Panes command and select Freeze Panes. And now you can see a thin line in between rows 2 and 3, and also a line between columns A and B. When I scroll, I can see all of my header rows and columns no matter where I am in the spreadsheet. Sometimes you may need to work with different parts of the spreadsheet at the same time. There are a couple of ways to do this. One is to click the New Window command on the View tab. This will give you two separate windows, and you may need to rearrange them so that you can view both at the same time. Both of these windows are showing the same file, and we can use it to view two different parts of the worksheet. Or, if the workbook has multiple sheets, you can view two of them side by side. So I could view the 2013 sales in one window, and the 2014 sales in another, which makes it very easy to compare the 2 years. If you want to go back to just one window, you can close either one by clicking the Close button in the upper right corner. You can then resize the window as needed or just click the Maximize button. Another way to view two different parts of a worksheet is to use the Split feature. This is a little bit like freezing panes, except instead of freezing them, you can actually scroll each section independently. First, if you have any frozen panes, you'll need to go back to the Freeze Panes command, then choose Unfreeze Panes. Then, select the cell where you want the split to appear, usually somewhere near the middle of your spreadsheet, and then click the Split command. And now you can see that there are vertical and horizontal dividers. There are also four scroll bars, which we can use to scroll the different sections. Now, if you find that this view is a little bit too cluttered, you can make it simpler by removing one of the dividers. If you drag the vertical divider all the way to the left, it will disappear, and you just have a horizontal divider. Now by scrolling the top and bottom sections, we can compare the data for any two salespeople really easily. For example, how about David Carlson and Melissa Post? Depending on your spreadsheet, some of these view options may be better than others. In this example, the header rows and columns are really important, so the Freeze Panes feature is probably our best choice. You'll want to try all of the view options and see which one works best for your spreadsheet.